nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to our reorg meeting, and first order of business are the oaths. So, Lee, you're up.
Okay, if you want to say a little, or you?
Wherever you guys are comfortable, it's fine.
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
Can you repeat after me?
Sure.
I, Lisa Herbert.
I, Lisa Herbert.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of trustee of the Board of Education.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of Board of.
Trustee.
Trustee of the Board of Education.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Thank you.
And Heather received her oath on July 1st. Congratulations.
Thank you, Heather.
Thank you. And then we have the appointment of the district clerk, so I need a motion to appoint Ms. Willett.
Move it.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
And we need the oath, please.
Repeat after me, please. I, Carmen, can you say it?
I, Carmen Willett.
Willett. Do solemnly affirm.
Solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
That I will faithfully discharge the duties of district clerk.
I will faithfully discharge the duties of district clerk.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Okay, next is the election of the president of the Board of Education. If anybody has any nominations, I nominate Andrea Parisi.
I also nominate Andrea Parisi.
Okay. So I guess I need a motion, or was that the second? I need a motion to elect Andrea Parisi for the Board of Education president.
Second.
Who moved it, who seconded?
Lisa moved it, I seconded.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, Andrea, congratulations.
Okay.
Oh, you're sorry.
Yes.
Sorry, Carmen.
Repeat after me, I, Andrea Parisi.
I, Andrea Parisi.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of Board of Education president.
And that I will faithfully discharge the responsibilities of Board of Education president. Duties. The Board of Education president.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
So now we're up to agenda item 3G, which is to nominate the vice president of the Board of Education. So I would like to see if there's any nominations.
I would like to nominate Stacey Stark.
Okay, so we need a motion for agenda item 3G to nominate Stacey Stark as vice president of the Board of Education.
Move it.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
I, Stacey Stark.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of Board of Education Vice President.
The duties of Board of Education Vice President.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
For the Seaford Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Agenda item 3I would be appointment of vice district clerk. Natalie Pettisich is willing to take on that position, but she's not here this evening, so she will take her oath as soon as possible. So we still need a motion, right?
Yeah.
So I need a motion for agenda item 3I, for Natalie Pettisic to be vice district clerk.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so we're gonna move on to agenda item 3K. The district clerk administrators the oath of office to Dr. Adele Pecora, superintendent of schools. It's your turn, Dr. Pecora.
Hi, Dr. Adele Pecora.
Hi, Dr. Adele Pecora.
Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of superintendent of schools.
The duties of superintendent of schools.
For the Sacred Union Free School District.
For the Sacred Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Okay, so we can do agenda items 3L through N together. So I need a motion for agenda items 3L through N.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. All right, so I need a motion for agenda item 3O. So the school attorney administrators the oath to the deputy treasurer.
It's not a motion, it's just that, there's the oath.
Okay.
That's the oath. Last one.
Repeat after me. I, Carmen Willett.
Willett.
Willett, I'm sorry. Do solemnly affirm.
Do solemnly affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And the Constitution of the State of New York.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties.
I will faithfully discharge the duties.
Of deputy treasurer.
Of deputy treasurer.
For the Sacred Union Free School District.
For the Sacred Union Free School District.
According to the best of my ability.
Okay, so I can do the next few together. I can do 3P through double C. I need a motion.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So now we are up to. All right, so now we are up to our committees. So I need a motion for agenda items 3 double D through double F.
Move it.
Second.
Okay, so we're going to have a discussion. We're going to start off with the district-wide school safety team committee for the 22-23 school year. Is there any interest in anyone being on that committee?
Yes.
Anybody else?
I have some interest in this committee too, but I'm a little undecided between that and maybe the audit committee. I'm not really sure what, where I would be better suited. Part of me thinks maybe the safety team, just because I'm on the other committee for security guards and also my, you know, background as an enforcement, so I feel like maybe that would be a good fit, but.
I mean, I do, we're on that committee together.
Yes, yes.
And I'm not in law enforcement, but I, you know, I do work with that. I've been on the committee prior to.
Yeah.
My thought on you for the audit committee.
Yeah.
If I may.
Sure.
It has a lot to do with policy and procedure, and I know things that you're interested in. And it's a little bit of a deeper dive into some of that.
Yeah.
It's a great way for you to get into that and see, you know, the things that you're interested in. So, I mean, that's totally up to you.
I appreciate that. And, but logistically also, the, I think, I had read that the meetings for the safety committee are in the middle of that.
Breaker.
Yeah, and the audit committee meets at night, right? Yeah, that's easier in my schedule to, the audit.
The night?
Yeah. Okay, I'd be fine to go.
You'll want?
Yeah.
Okay. So, quick question, Stacy, do I need to go back and appoint you to the district-wide safety team?
Well, we did them together.
Okay.
We can do them, right, Carmen? We can do them, she made the motion to do them all together, so we can decide.
So, Stacy, you're gonna be part of the district-wide safety team.
Yes.
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 And then.
Okay, there's the wellness committee. Any discussion on any interest with, for the wellness committee?
I would like to. Do you know when the meetings are for that? Around the wellness meeting, or Kevin, when are they?
Typically, they get them at the school around 3:30.
Okay. Any particular day of the week, or is it just there?
Usually Monday through Thursday.
Okay.
They appoint Friday.
With your expertise in it? Yeah. I'll make it work.
Okay. And how many meetings are there a year? I think there's only a handful, right?
About four.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, figure it out.
Perfect.
Is there usually, like, you did kind of, who can make it the most on a particular day, and how you figure it out?
Exactly. So we waited for the elementary schools and, you know, the administration there and some of the teachers. So 3:45 usually work.
Okay. Great, fantastic. I need a motion for agenda item 3GG through triple M.
You made the motion. We seconded it.
Okay, so all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So now I need a motion for agenda item 3GG through triple M.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so we're up to Dr. Pecora's administrative report.
No questions. Yeah, we're up to?
Yes, we're up to you.
Okay, yeah. Okay. So,
Adele, excuse me. You went up to?
Triple M.
Triple M or triple?
Triple M.
Triple M.
Oh, yeah. Wait.
Okay, now you can go.
Hold on, wait.
I did triple M.
Triple M.
Triple M. Set M, yeah.
Sorry about that.
It's the air conditioning.
All right, so, couple of things. So first, I'd like to welcome Sheena to her very first board meeting as Assistant Superintendent for Human Resources and Instructional Support. She's done a really nice job transitioning and already very, very busy at work. So, it's great.
She's in Seaford Green, she's ready to go.
Ready to go. And then just, I know I've spoken to the board before about the number of infrastructure projects that we have going on during the summer. Just wanted to give you a brief update. It's good that Mr. Costa's here. So the demolition has begun on the Wellness Center at the middle school where the room was gutted, lighting has come out, asbestos abatement has been done. At the high school, we have two brand new science rooms. Those of you who historically have been secret people, it's the chemistry room. The red and the blue rooms are going to be reconstructed. All of that's using our federal funds, and the ventilation will be better, the equipment will be better, and they'll be state-of-the-art facilities. The wellness center is crucial to, I think, providing a safe space for the kids at the middle school. The wellness center at the high school is hugely popular, and the kids really use it, and it's been a nice vehicle. Available for the kids. So we're looking forward to those two construction projects. Those are running simultaneously with the doors here and the locks that are on this door. They're fully installed at the manor and they're fully installed at the high school. It really is a matter of who put all the orders in, which orders came in first. So the harbor and the middle school are supposed to be coming in by any day now, right?
They're set to ship on July 11th.
Okay.
And they should take about a week or so to get to the contractor and the installer. I will be in contact with them this week, you know, wait a little bit just to make sure we're still on schedule, and, you know, we'll work with him to get them installed. You know, my plan is to have it done before the end, before the end of the summer, before school starts, barring any, you know, issues or, you know, things that are out of our control as far as deliveries and things like that.
So the harbor will be first, and then the middle school. And we hope to get all of that done before the start of the school year. I do want to give a shout out to the administrative team at the high school. They did a phenomenal job orchestrating graduation. This is the first year that we're doing it over at Hofstra. Last year, as everybody knows, we did it at the Tilla Center. We originally switched to Hofstra because we weren't sure with vaccination requirements whether we'd be able to use the Tilla Center. And it just turned out to even be, I think, a better venue than even Tills. It's beautiful, but it was an appropriate size. They were very accommodating. It was really beautiful ceremony. She did a great job for, you have to keep in mind, this is a brand new team. So Dr. Murray's been there a year. Mr. Murray's been there less than a year, 4 or 5 months. And Ms. Schnagel, it's her first year as principal, and they just did a phenomenal job. So a huge shout out to them for doing a great job. The kids have
motion, we can do it together, is that okay? Okay, 5A through E2.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, resident comments? Anyone has any comments, if you could please come up and just state your name and address. All quiet this evening. Correspondence, I don't believe there were any, we discussed that. So I need a motion for agenda item 8A1 through... Eight.
I'm sorry.
Through eight, right there.
Eight.
Yep. So it's 8A1.
Eight.
Through eight.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Yep. 8B, I need a motion for agenda item 8B1.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, and for the resolutions, I need a motion for agenda item 8C1 through 3.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, so now miscellaneous discussion items, Ms. Stark is going to speak on behalf of that item on the agenda.
So Nassau Southern School Boards, we got an invitation to join the Nassau Southern School Boards again. We ceased our affiliation with them a few years ago. It cost, I think it was $3,500 or $4,000 or something like that. One of our board members in the past was on the Nassau Southern School Board, and that was the only time we ever got an update from them. It's the only time we ever heard from them once he was no longer on it. We never heard anything. And then this past year, they wrote a letter saying they were representing all of the school boards in the state, stating that this is what everybody wanted, but they didn't consult with anyone. It's not something that I would recommend. I don't think it's worth our money. We are part of NISBA, the New York State School Boards Association, who does try to listen to us and involve us. They send out a ton of stuff. We get a lot of stuff from them. So I don't, I don't think that there's value in it, but if anybody else, I mean, the information was in the packet, yep. So you saw what they do, what they say they do. So,
yeah,
we're good.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
That's good. A no comment, thank you.
Did you guys something to say?
Nope.
Okay. No. Alrighty, so before closing comments from the board administration, I need to adjourn the public meeting and move into a public hearing to review the safety plan of the district. Yes, I need a motion to move in. So we're going to adjourn the public portion of the meeting and move into a public hearing for purpose of reviewing our safety plan. I need a motion.
Move it.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Make an announcement before we go into the hearing. So I did want to make reference to the fact that Ms. Dolan is in the back of the room. We are appointed for tonight for point four reading teacher.
So this stays on the district's internet for 30 days for discussion, is that right? Correct me if I'm wrong, Dr. Flora. This is up for 30 days?
It's up for 30 days.
Mm-hmm.
For public comments.
Yep.
And anybody that has comments can email the board or email me.
Okay.
So Mr. Costa usually has a few words just to say.
Okay.
Good evening. Okay, so New York State Safe legislation requires that the district hold a 30-day public comment period regarding the district-wide health and safety plan. The plan will be posted on the district website. After a mandatory 30 days, the Seaford Unit-Free School Board of Education will adopt the plan. Once it's adopted, then the district will be able to post that to the New York State Education Department website. That will then be the plan, and a link to that plan will then be put
on our website as well. So there is a 30-day comment. After that 30 days, the board will adopt the plan, and then going forward, that becomes our plan, and it's official.
Great. And we just do want to point out that this is our district plan, and the building plans are confidential and are not posted to the website.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely.
And there were just a couple of things in the plan. I know Ms. Stark did email you. I'm sure it was discussed. I have a question, just that the parent volunteer, does that go out against the parents, or does this parent, does the parent stay on like year after year? It's the safety team, is that, was something sent out for?
With regards to whether the membership is a rollover, or
right,
whether
or
a new
parent maybe wanted
on,
to come on?
We typically ask if somebody wants to continue in that
okay.
spot, and if not, then we'll put it out and we'll send out an email requesting if anybody's interested in joining the committee.
Okay, and on page 9, that early dismissal drill, is that, it says that parents are to be notified 1 week prior to the drill. Does that typically happen, or is it already pre-decided when that is?
It's on the calendar.
It's on the calendar early, so it's not a week.
Well, it's usually, but it's at least
right.
a week ahead of time.
That's the notice, that's what's constantly noticed on the calendar.
I always get emails.
I was going to say the principals do put it in their backpack news.
Okay.
And they do notify, the teachers notify the students. With an early dismissal, we want to make sure that
sure.
children are received, so
right.
it is very well publicized.
So it's
yeah.
not 1 week prior, that's right, correct? Because I know
it's at least 1 week
at least,
prior.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So maybe 1 week, yeah, because it's right before a holiday. It's like the last day before a holiday break, so it's not the week prior. And, you know, there was just some, like, tech issues of Wi-Fi connections, so when doing drills, just checking that we have connections. You know, I know parents were concerned about using cell phones in school, or you know, the connection being poor when you're in the building. So when those drills are done, or do we check that it's the Wi-Fi is connected and messages are getting to the right places?
Well, there's a couple of things. Like in each classroom, there's a hardwired phone in each classroom
okay.
that connects to, you can contact any other classroom and you can contact the main office.
Okay.
So there's always a vehicle for the classroom teacher or anybody in that classroom to communicate with anybody internally within the building.
Okay.
So you can't call 911
from that phone? No.
From a hardwired phone?
No.
And if you can't, use your cell phone to call 911 because you don't have good service.
That's
our potential issue there.
So we would,
you know, typically.
Because you don't want to call the main office to say there is a
threat or
something's happening right now.
Yeah.
That's a middleman that's.
That's the concern.
So it's
something
to
bring up in the safety.
It's something
security
that
security guard.
Well, not security guard, but the district-wide safety committee.
Yeah.
We can talk about the. Right now, the cell phones are not connected to our Wi-Fi, and it's a matter of whether we do because the number of devices that we're already having. The difference between one devices and then the teacher devices and the devices in the office. So the question is whether we open.
There's no like internet blocker, right? There's
okay,
no.
But what I'm going to say is, most of the time when they're doing it, they're not connected to the Wi-Fi to make a phone call. You're using your 5G or 4G.
Right. Using
you're not using
data.
Wi-Fi.
Right. But that kind of.
So Wi-Fi. The only
next question
Wi-Fi
is nothing
would
blocking,
be.
Right? Some schools have like an internet blocker. Like you can't use your phone. They don't want people on their devices.
No, there's no blockers.
We don't. Our phones are not connected to our network. So individual phones are not connected. That's where the block is. So district-wide, we do not have phones on our network because, what I said before, because there's so many devices. Well, if you're calling 911, you're not using Wi-Fi to call 911. You're using your 5G to call 911.
Right. I think sometimes a school or just if you're out like in a governmental building, sometimes you can't even connect to your data. You can't use 5G. Like there's just a block there.
Well, we don't have a block on the 5G. We just
right.
have.
You just don't
have.
Right.
Just don't
have
good
right. Right. Right.
Like
that doesn't have anything to do with our Wi-Fi.
Right.
That's Verizon or AT&T.
Right. So that has nothing to do with our internal
right.
infrastructure.
Right. That's what I wanted to make
right.
sure. But right, it doesn't. I guess lead to the other issue. But yes.
Right. there's just poor connection. Like, I go into some rooms and I have better connection than others here.
Right.
Right, like right now I'll have service.
A lot of these rooms are in the cinder block.
Yes, yes, the cinder block, so absolutely.
So you're sitting by a window.
Yep, the connection's better. Okay, so that's something we can look into. And just on page 37.
But there's not much we can do about that. That's, you're using your cell phone, that's a 5G network. We can look into having outside lines, well, that dial 911, but we can't look into the use of personal devices and enhancing connectivity.
Wi-Fi here, sure.
Right. Well, not Wi-Fi. It's not Wi-Fi when you're using your phone.
It's just your ability to.
Just your cell.
Yes, it's a tower issue.
Right. So I just want to separate that. If you're talking about, I can't send out an email, that's different than a text or.
Right.
Or a phone call. A text or a phone call is the 5G.
Right.
We don't have control over that.
Okay. And just the date here was wrong? On 37. Folded. There's a typo.
Which date?
On page 37. It's just a typo in March. That was it.
Oh. But which one is
37 at the top, bold, right? It says M-A-R-C-C.
Oh, March is spelled
correctly?
Yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, two C's and it should be a slash.
Yeah.
Minor. You got it on there?
I do. And I spelled it
did.
Fine. Okay. All right.
We need to exit to public hearing and go back into.
Make a motion to exit public hearing and back into our public meeting.
Move it.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so we're at the end of our agenda. So I'm going to ask for closing comments from the board. I'll start with
Sarita. I'm just happy to be on board. It's I have a lot to learn, but I'm excited to work with everybody. So thank you.
Just want to congratulate Heather on your new position here, and to everybody's new positions. Congratulations to Andrea becoming president, and everybody else. Just
everyone can take my comments now.
Whatever you want.
You go.
Congratulations and welcome. Thank you to, as Dr. McCora said, the high school administration. The 8 years that I've been going to the graduations, I think that this was the best venue, the most personal, just in general, the most personal graduation. I thought it was fantastic. All the graduations were great. It was a nice ending to another rough school year. So moving on, hopefully next year I'll just get better each year from now. So that's it.
Just welcome Heather.
Thank you.
And congratulations to Cynthia. It's like the first day of school. I love the reorg meeting because it is like a fresh new start with all of the reappointments. So I'm looking forward to it.
She's like the last one on board. What took you so long? I just want to reiterate what Stacy just said, that all the moving up ceremonies were just fantastic.
Really
starting
are.
With the harbor and the manor, and then the middle school, and then obviously the Pinnacle High School. Hofstra was a beautiful event. All the work that went into it was just great. So it was a nice way to kind of wrap up the year, and I know Sheena and I are both looking forward to starting off 22-23.
For anyone that didn't see the email or text message, There is our summer experience camp running for 2 weeks. You can pick your week. It's at the Manor School, and that's a really great opportunity for students. So many students did it last year, and it was really well received. I love that the money is going towards something that can help our students grow academically and socially, and I hope any students take the opportunity to come.
I need a motion to adjourn the meeting and enter back into executive session for the employment history of particular employees and legal matters.
Move it. Second.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.